Let's clean up this mess. Road to no compromise vibraphone. Check this out. These are the 22 Matrix Sentinel marble gates for the new vibraphone drops. In the last episode, I built this vibraphone drop system with all the metal rails. And then I took the angle grinder and just removed like 10 days work. In this video, I will explain to you exactly why I needed to make this redesign. But before I explain that, I'm so excited to actually start to build this. So let's make some plywood pieces on the CNC.
Ever since I came up with the Matrix Sentinels for the drums of the Marble Machine X, I have been toying with the idea to use them for the vibraphone as well. It took me a day to design this assembly in CAD, and it consists of laser cut metal parts and CNC cut plywood parts. I'm going to start making these marble shuttles that feeds a marble every time a note is played. When I was at Thinkercon in Alabama, I met my maker idol, Frank Howarth. He has the same CNC machine as I have, and I asked him what end mills he's using for plywood, and he was compression bits. I had never heard of these kinds of end mills before. They're also called up and down, and the special thing is that the flute direction is changing in the middle of the end mill. So in the top of the end mill, it's cutting down, and in the bottom it's cutting up. So on the top of the plywood, the end mill will cut down, and on the bottom of the plywood, it will cut up, which results in much less tear out. Normally I had a great finish on the top of the plywood, but a little bit of tear out on the underside, which is expected when you're using the down cutters that I normally use. So I was really excited to see if this made a difference. To cut into tight corners, you need to use a smaller diameter tool, and I only had this up cutter for metal, and you can actually see how it's leaving a little bit of tear out on the top there, just because it's an up cutter. At this moment, I realized I forgot toolpaths for some unique marble shutters that has a relief cut to clear these washers. I also saw that I had some interference on some relief cuts. I needed to redesign them to make them longer. And I checked the simulation for this extra cut very carefully to not ruin my already cut pieces. Today, me and the CNC machine were kind of best friends, and it did exactly what I asked it to do.
Okay, there's only one single operation left to do for these marble shuttles before they're completed. I need to pilot drill two holes for the L hooks. And old Martin would just go to the drill press and hope for the best. But new Martin knows that when you have a repetitive job like this to pilot drill 44 holes and I want them accurate, it's better to invest some time in setting up the operation. So I'm going to do this on the CNC machine, do it properly.
I cut three locating slots with different tolerances and found that the middle one had the perfect press fit. And here I'm using a custom-made mallet that a French maker and YouTuber sent me, Olivier Verdier. He has a fantastic channel, so check him out on YouTube. It does feel very proper to locate these plywood pieces with a custom plywood mallet. Thank you, Olivier. I love the mallet and I love the Puy lentils as well. Here I'm reaping the rewards from my upfront time investment in making this into a CNC operation. It's just to repeat the same toolpath over and over again, and the results are immaculate. Love it.
Close. Livet är en sand som i ett timglas rinner. Låt oss leva upp den lilla tid vi hinner. Åh, det dyra liv som tynar och försvinner. Livet är en sand som i ett timglas rinner. Me and Wilson has leveled up enough to take on the mini boss of the assembly, the bottom plywood part here. You can see that it has a 7-degree tilt, and that is because the marble shuttles are moving perpendicular to the Marble Machine X, but the vibraphone is mounted at a 7-degree angle. I started by drilling holes for M5 bolts, and then I used a ball end cutter to cut these apple-shaped marble grooves. Then I used a 2mm end mill to cut the internal walls slot. Those slots will separate the two marbles in each apple. Here I'm using a 3mm bit to cut the thin groove for the vertical L-hook that will go straight through this plywood piece, and I ran into a problem with this operation. The wood chips had nowhere to go, and they got packed up and they broke off this little tool.
I tried redesigning the tool paths and using another tool, but I ended up breaking that as well, so I redesigned the tool paths again. In the end, I solved this by cutting only 4mm deep and then pausing the machine and vacuum cleaning out all the wood chips out of the groove, then cutting 4mm again, vacuum cleaning, and then 4mm deeper, and so on, until I was through the whole plywood. Definitely learned a lesson here to actually plan for proper chip evacuation on tight operations like these. Here I'm using that same compression bit that I talked about in the beginning of the video again. I'm cutting the larger internal slots, and then I'm cutting the contour. And I have to say, it works so much better than a straight down cutter. The result is actually perfect. There's no fraying or no tear out on the bottom of the plywood, and that saves me a lot of sanding and just generally leaves a more professional looking part. I I don't remember when I made those burn marks. I must have welded on top of this plywood or something, but they will be hidden inside this assembly, so no worries. On the top of the assembly we have these PMMA pipes and the marbles come through them into this 20 degree wedge transition piece. And looking at the top of the piece we can see that we have spaced the holes to fit the PMMA pipes. But when the marbles go through this transition wedge they go closer to each other, which means that I have to split this piece to be able to machine this shape on a 3-axis CNC machine. If we look from the front you can clearly see how the transition from the PMMA pipes goes narrower in through the top metal piece. Setting up the tool pass for this operation was by far the most complicated because I had to indicate the pieces correctly and I had to be able to turn them 90 degrees and machine them from different sides. I started by cutting the two long plywood rectangles. I plan to use the resulting pocket for indication. I forgot to hog out the radius in the corners, so I'm just doing that manually here, and now you can see that my plywood rectangles can indicate perfectly into the corner of the pocket. By doing it this way, the machine knows exactly where my plywood rectangles are situated, and I can start the machining of the shapes. I left rectangular blocks on the side of the piece so I can take them out when I'm done machining from one side, turn them exactly 90 degrees, indicate them towards the same corner, and run the next toolpath machining from a completely new direction. This way I can achieve the quote-unquote impossible shapes on this 3-axis CNC. So in this little plywood wedge, there are 22 marble paths that go at a compound angle. And I really love the challenge to try to make these kind of difficult 3D shapes on a 3-axis CNC machine from plywood. I think it's really fun. When I first heard about CNC machines, I thought they worked like this. You put the machine in your workshop, you put the power on, and you press start. While the machine is making your perfect part, you do this. That is not the case in my case. It actually feels more like this. There's a lot of manual labor. The machine is actually really, really stupid in itself. If you tell it to do something, it will do it even if it's a bad idea. And to figure out what is a good or bad idea is entirely on your shoulders. But this is a specific rabbit hole that I really love in the Marble Machine X process. I never get tired of cutting Baltic birch plywood on the CNC.
Great. We're done with the plywood parts procurement of this assembly. I have to wait for the metal parts from the laser cutting place until we can put this together and put it on the machine. In the beginning of time, I made an assumption. In engineering, you should not assume anything. My assumption was that the vibraphone bar wants to be hit in the middle. So we designed these holders for that. Then you guys helped out by posting brilliant comments saying that there's better sound off-center. When this information reached me, we had already made these vibraphone holders. So I made a video showing that I'm gonna do a compromise. It was hitting closer to the sweet spot, but not at the sweet spot. But I thought that was going to be okay. You guys, again, were like screaming in the comment field, why don't you just shift the bars like this? And I was like, ah, no, the resonator pipe has to be centered, I thought. And then I made a test and the resonator pipe was super happy to be off center. So even moving a centimeter from The vibraphone is a lead singer of the Marble Machine X band. It requires a very, very special conditions to perform. Basically a needy bastard. I don't know if that has a trait for lead singers, but anyway. I'm a needy bastard band leader myself. I just don't sing. Your suggestion proved to be absolutely, probably the best. And I hope you understand why I assumed what I assumed at the time. And now when I have the whole picture, I can see this much more clearly. The vibraphone was just screaming for the Matrix Sentinel's solution. Thank you for commenting and thanks for helping out with this build. I'm really touched by the amazing support from the crowdfunding campaign, all the new Wintergatan backers who are supporting my dream. I talk about it more and more. It's because it's growing and becoming more and more important. I can hire help around me. It frees up my time to actually think about just where a marble should hit a vibraphone plate. I could not live with this horrible harmonic when we could have a clean transient with a good fundamental of the singer of the Marble Machine X. Thank you for watching. See you on the next video. What? Yay! The milestone I never wanted to reach, okay? I just want to say seriously thanks for following this journey. Click like on this video if you believe I can avoid episode 1000.